So my homie Azamat and I like cars. This is my G80 and I bought myself. Nabil just borrowing it.
Today we're installing this big thing on the back of the Supra here. So this is kind of the old Mark 4 Supra style wing. And it's made for the Mark 5. It's fully carbon. I'm not gonna say it's the lightest thing out there, it's pretty heavy, because I think there is multiple layers of carbon and it's probably impregnated with something else, but honestly, very nice piece, very nice high quality carbon. So let's see how it looks on the Supra itself.
So this is the actual spoiler itself, and this is from who?
Seibon.
I do remember seeing that now. Seibon carbon fiber spoiler. So the first thing we need to do to get this job done is remove this. We thought we could try to keep it, but at this point this is gonna have to come off. So if anyone is looking for a carbon fiber spoiler for their Mark 5 Supra, we'll probably sell this at a decent price, or are you gonna keep it?
And I'll sell it, decent price.
Yeah, so if anyone wants one, message me on Instagram or message him. I'll put his Instagram down in the description below and I'm sure you'll get it for a good deal. But let's go ahead and get this thing removed. This is gonna be kind of annoying, and then we can start installing that and it should be pretty easy. We got the old spoiler off. Thank God for us, there's not much tape and it's coming off pretty well. So we'll just clean this up real quick and... No, Amazon truck out of the way. Can't see it. But this is the old spoiler compared to the new wing now. So huge difference compared to both. So this is the old one. As you can tell, it's kind of more of a duckbill, and then this is an actual spoiler, like a big wing. So this is how the car is looking right now. Not much to do. I was really thinking that we're gonna have a bunch of extra tape and stuff, but should be good. We'll go ahead and remove all that, clean it up, and start the installation process of that thing.
So the first thing you're gonna wanna do is remove the bolts that come in the spoiler itself. So it's a 10 mil, you just go ahead or remove it. From there, I'll show you guys what these other tabs are that come with the kit. These are gonna be very helpful. And if you guys saw the recent M4 wing install, you saw that we had to do a lot of calculation just to make sure everything was accurate and we're drilling all the holes in the right place. And luckily with this kit, we won't have to do that because of those tabs. So once you have these and your bolts are removed, you're just gonna simply go ahead and place this in there, just like that. And then take a small bit of tape. Don't take a lot, just because you kind of need this to pull apart. Just put a little bit of tape on there, hold it in place, just like so. And then you're gonna do the same thing with this back piece. And I'm just gonna show you guys on the car itself. This will guide where you're gonna drill. So once you have your final placement of the spoiler on the car, so somewhat like that, right? You will know, you just tape these pieces down, make sure they stay on the car, and wherever that center piece of this plastic is, you just know that you drill right through that and it should line up on your spoiler perfectly. So we're gonna go ahead and do that real quick on both sides, and we'll get to the installation process.
So this is what I was referring to with the tabs. You make sure you just tape them down so they don't move. You did that on both sides. So now, let me hold these tabs down just to make sure. Come on, pull up on your end. Go ahead, keep on, right? And then same thing on this side. Go ahead.
Oh yeah.
So now we know exactly where we need to drill. Right here, right here, right here, and right here. So that gives us exact drill locations on the spoiler itself, and it'll be to the exact same look or mock-up that we just had. So now it's just a matter of drilling those in. Some weather stripping, and should be pretty simple. We'll show you guys the weather stripping process and how to make it waterproof and so on in a second here, but we'll go ahead and start drilling first and then go from there.
Just put it straight in. Wrong side, and that's it. It went through both the trunk and the plastic on the inner skin.
Now your taillight's out.
So yeah, do both on that side, and then after that we're just gonna work our way up until we get to the size of the bolt itself, which is about, I think, a 1/4 drill bit size. So
we'll work our way up, and then after that, it's just a matter of putting the weather stripping on, like I mentioned, and putting it in. So honestly, Seibon has made it very easy to install this thing. Usually it takes a lot longer, like the M4 video, like I mentioned, took a lot longer to just measure everything. This honestly took 10 minutes, 15 minutes.
I think the M4 is a user issue.
Yeah. It's probably a user issue. But yeah.
Nothing, right? That's
changing.
Oh, fuck.
Whoa! Whoa! Super. We got all the holes drilled to size. I think the size that we went up to was a 15 to 64. So this is the weather stripping, right? And it's just as simple as taking it right across the edge here. It doesn't need to be perfect because it is going to kind of get smushed. So I'm going to keep it like a millimeter towards the inside so it doesn't show on the outside. And just work your way around the entire base of the spoiler. Go all the way up until the edge, and here we can just cut off any of the excess, just like that. It matches up pretty well with the trunk line, so now it's just a matter of tightening these two up. I'm not going to tighten them all the way until he gets his side situated. You want me to do it? I can do it.
Yeah, that looks insane. That's actually like, that's perfect.
Oh, that looks really good.
It looks so good.
It's so much better.
That looks really good. Yeah.
Nice. The other one looks good too on it, but this adds a lot to it. Even the other wing most people put on, uh-huh. That more aggressive look, that one's also solid, but I just really like this with fully carbon.
I honestly really like the fact that Seibon thought about the actual installation process, didn't just make a great product. They made it very easy to install this thing and measure out where the exact spoiler sits on the trunk of the vehicle. Like I said, this took all of, what, 30 minutes?
That's it.
Yeah, 30 minutes. Definitely. Usually, this takes so much longer. Looking solid. You don't have to worry about any water getting into the trunk or nothing. And yeah. Honestly, so I'll pull it out to the street real quick. We can see it from like the side angle. That looks good, man. Why are you walking like that?
Just like a,
you know, I'm talking, right?
That
looks really nice.
Damn.
And I think it just adds on to the aesthetic of like the Mk4 Supra, since it is the same style wing. I think it just looks really good on the car, and honestly it makes it a lot more aggressive. Now you just need wheels, honestly.
That's
and
like the next thing.
Yeah.
I'm hoping like a couple months.
So once he gets the new wheels on, this thing should be looking real pretty. I think he really loves how that looks. Super excited. But yeah, I think for this video, that's gonna be it. This is 2 weeks in a row we've done spoiler installs. So we're kind of getting good at this, and honestly seeing these two guys get them on their cars, I kind of want one on the G80. And when we mocked up the M4 spoiler on the G80, it looked really good. So who knows, we might have to get the Adro or the Vorsteiner swan neck spoiler on the G80 itself. But we got a lot of plans coming for this car. We got PPF on the way, hopefully. We also have, hopefully, some new wheels that we're gonna be buying pretty soon here, coilover kit, and then a few other mods. So this car is definitely gonna get the treatment pretty soon here. We can't let these other guys continue modding their cars without modding ours. So for today, I think that's gonna be it. I appreciate you all watching, and I'll see you guys on the next one. Peace.